Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a complete course for the CCNP ENCOR, Enterprise Core exam. This course will cover all topics you need to know to pass the ENCOR exam. In this video, we'll continue our study of spanning tree protocol by looking at the STP states and timers. This is material you should have learned in your CCNA studies, but there is always room to dig deeper and learn more about a topic, and that's what we'll do in this video. Here's what we'll cover. First, we'll cover the STP states, blocking, listening, learning, forwarding, and also disabled, which just refers to a disabled port. Then we'll cover the three main STP timers, the hello timer, forward delay timer, and max age timer. And we'll also connect these two topics by looking at how these timers govern how STP ports transition through the different states. Let's get started. Here's an overview of the STP states. Blocking and forwarding are the two stable port states. So after the network has converged and is stable, all ports should either be in the STP blocking or forwarding state. Route and designated ports are stable in the forwarding state, and non-designated ports are stable in the blocking state. The listening and learning states are transitional. In a stable, converged network, no ports should be in these states. Route and designated ports will move through the listening and learning states in that order before finally moving to the forwarding state. Finally, there is the disabled state, which refers to ports that are disabled and therefore not active in STP, such as error disabled or otherwise shut down ports. I won't mention the disabled state anymore, but it is considered the fifth STP state, so you should be aware of it. Let's look at each state in greater detail, starting with the blocking state. Non-designated ports are stable in a blocking state. In the blocking state, ports do not receive, forward, or flood regular frames. They do not forward STP BPDUs, although they do process BPDUs that they receive, so they can react if they receive a BPDU that indicates a change in the topology. However, blocking ports do not learn MAC addresses from frames they receive. This port state is the key to STP, because STP works by blocking redundant links to avoid layer 2 loops. Next, the listening state, which route and designated ports both transition through. Ports in the listening state do not send or receive regular frames, however they do forward STP BPDUs if their role is designated. However, they still don't learn MAC addresses from received frames. After the forward delay timer has expired, route and designated ports will transition to the learning state. In this state, they still don't receive, forward, or flood regular frames. However, they do forward STP BPDUs, process received BPDUs, and they start learning MAC addresses from frames received on the port. Finally, there is the forwarding state, the stable state for route and designated ports. Ports in this state are fully operational. They receive, forward, and flood regular frames, forward STP BPDUs, process received BPDUs, and learn MAC addresses from the frames they receive. For a quick review, here's a chart summarizing what we just covered. Next, we'll move on to the STP timers, but we'll also look at these port states when looking at the relationship between the STP states and timers. Pause the video if you want to look through this chart. So here are the three STP timers: hello, forward delay, and max age. Let's take a brief look at each using this chart, and then dig a bit deeper. The hello timer determines how often the root bridge sends hello BPDUs, and the default timer is 2 seconds. So every 2 seconds, the root bridge will send BPDUs out of its designated ports. Then, other switches that receive those BPDUs will forward them out of their designated ports. The forward delay timer determines how long a port will stay in the listening and learning states, and the default is 15 seconds. Note that it's 15 seconds for each state, so 30 seconds in total. Then, the max age timer determines how long a BPDU received on a port remains valid. In other words, it's how long a port will wait after ceasing to receive BPDUs to change the STP topology. If a port stops receiving BPDUs, it will wait 20 seconds before actually doing anything. This is to ensure that the STP topology remains stable, and missing one or two BPDUs doesn't cause the entire topology to change. Let's look at each timer in more detail. First up, the Hello timer. It determines how often the root bridge sends configuration BPDUs. In a future video, I'll talk about the other type of BPDU, the topology change notification BPDU. Upon receiving a BPDU on its root port, a switch will forward the BPDU out of its designated ports. So the Hello timer of the root bridge determines how often non-root switches will forward BPDUs. Like this, BPDUs originate from the root bridge and are propagated throughout the LAN, each switch modifying some parameters of the BPDUs they forward. And then 2 seconds later, the same thing happens again. This happens every 2 seconds by default. To modify the Hello timer, use the spanning tree VLAN Hello time command, specifying the Hello timer in seconds. The configurable range is 1 second to 10 seconds. So, if I use this command on switch 1, it will send BPDUs every second, instead of every 2 seconds. After issuing that command, I used show spanning tree on switch 5, and in the root bridge section of the output, you can see the new Hello timer of 1 second. However, under the section containing switch 5's own information, it still says 2 seconds. Switch 5's own Hello timer won't actually take effect though. It only matters if switch 5 is the root bridge. Because the root bridge, switch 1, sends BPDUs every second, switch 5 will forward them every second, after it receives them. Now let's look at the forward delay timer. It determines how long root and designated ports remain in the listening and learning states. After a port is enabled, for example connected to a neighbor, or enabled with no shutdown, and then initialized, which can take a second or two, it will become a designated port in the listening state, until its final role is determined. If it becomes a non-designated port, it will immediately transition to the blocking state. No need to wait for the forward delay timer. If it becomes a root or designated port, it will remain in the listening state until the forward delay timer expires, and then transition to learning. Then, it will remain in the learning state until the forward delay timer expires, and then transition to forwarding. So, the whole process from port initialization to forwarding takes 30 seconds in classic STP. Our STP speeds this up quite a bit, and for ports connected to end hosts, you can use portfast. But the standard STP process takes 30 seconds. Note that if at any point it is determined that the port should be non-designated instead of root or designated, it will immediately transition to blocking. And if it's determined that a non-designated port should become root or designated, it will transition to forwarding via listening and learning, via the same 30-second process. You can modify the timer with the spanning tree VLAN forward time command in global config mode. And note that the forward delay timer of the root bridge will be used by all other switches. Let's see the port state transitions in the CLI, focusing on the link between switch 4 and switch 5 from the topology I showed before. On switch 4 and switch 5, I enabled STP event debugging with debug spanning tree event. Then I connected the two switches together, and noticed that both of their ports enter the listening state, as shown in the debug output. However, switch 5 soon determines that its port should be non-designated, and it then transitions the port to the blocking state. Switch 4's port, however, remains a designated port. Look at the timestamps of the switch 4 output. At 8:54:13, G01 entered the listening state. Then, 15 seconds after it entered the listening state, switch 4's port enters the learning state at 8:54:28. And finally, 15 seconds after entering the learning state, it enters the forwarding state at 8:54:43. So, as you can see from the timestamps, the listening and learning states were 15 seconds each, the length of the forward delay timer. The entire transition from listening to forwarding took 30 seconds. Next, let's look at the max age timer. This timer determines how long a BPDU's information will remain valid. So, for example, if a switch stops receiving BPDUs on a port, it will still save the information of the latest BPDU it received for the duration of the max age timer. It won't immediately change the STP topology. Let's look at another situation, in which a switch doesn't stop receiving BPDUs, but instead starts receiving inferior BPDUs. So the switch 2 to switch 4 link goes down. Because switch 4's root port went down, it doesn't need to wait for the max age timer to make a change. It immediately reacts. It sees that it no longer has a path to the root bridge, so it declares itself the root bridge. It doesn't know switch 1 is still alive and well. It just knows that its root port went down, and it's not receiving BPDUs from switch 5, because switch 5's port is non-designated. So, considering itself the root bridge, switch 4 starts sending its own BPDUs to switch 5. However, these BPDUs are inferior to the BPDUs from switch 1 it was forwarding to switch 5 before. They are also inferior to the ones switch 5 still receives from switch 1 via switch 2. So, switch 5 ignores switch 4's new BPDUs until the old BPDU information times out, as determined by the max age timer. Remember, before switch 4's root port went down, it was forwarding BPDUs from switch 1 to switch 5. Switch 5 saves the information of the last BPDU it received on that port for the duration of the max age timer, and ignores the new inferior BPDUs from switch 4. After the max age timer expires, switch 5 finally reacts to switch 4's inferior BPDUs. Its port becomes designated, and it forwards switch 1's superior BPDUs to switch 4. And then, switch 4 accepts switch 1 as the root bridge again, and its port becomes a root port. We'll cover more about STP topology changes like this in a future video. The default max age timer is 20 seconds. However, the rate at which BPDUs actually age out depends on the switch's distance from the root bridge. When a switch receives a BPDU, it subtracts that BPDU's age from the max age timer. The root bridge sends BPDUs with age 0. The switches connected to the root bridge send BPDUs with age 1, so switch 2 in this case. Then, switch 4 and switch 5 send BPDUs with age 2. You can see that here in this packet capture I did on the link between switch 5 and switch 6. Switch 5 sends BPDUs with age 2 to switch 6. So this means that BPDUs switch 2 and switch 3 receive, from switch 1, will age out in 20 seconds, the total max age timer. BPDUs switch 4 and switch 5 receive from switch 2 will age out in 19 seconds, 20 minus 1. BPDUs switch 5 receives from switch 4 will age out in 18 seconds, 20 minus 2, and the same goes for BPDUs switch 6 receives from switch 5. The farther away from the root bridge, the faster the BPDUs age out. You can modify the max age timer with the spanning tree VLAN max age command. And like the other timers, the max age timer of the root bridge will be used by all other switches. Here's what we covered in this video, the STP states and timers. And we also looked at how the STP timers govern STP state transitions, how the forward delay timer governs transitions to the forwarding state, and how the max age timer governs how quickly a switch reacts to a change in the topology. Although we covered these topics in the CCNA, we did cover some more details in this video, so hopefully you learned something new. Now let's do a quiz to test your understanding. Here's quiz question 1. Examine the following output. Which of the following statements are true? Select 2. Pause the video now to think about the answers. Okay, the answers are B and D. That is because it is the timers of the root bridge, not the timers configured on switch 5 itself, that determine how switch 5 operates. The root bridge has a hello timer of 1, so switch 5 will forward BPDUs out of its designated ports every second, each time it receives BPDUs from the root bridge. And the root bridge's forward delay timer is 15 seconds. So, switch 5's root and designated ports will take a total of 30 seconds to reach the forwarding state. Okay, let's go to question 2. Which state can a port immediately transition to from any other state. Pause the video now to think about the answer. Okay, the answer is A, blocking. As this diagram shows, a port can immediately transition to the blocking state from listening, learning, or forwarding. Although STP is cautious about transitioning a port to the forwarding state to avoid causing layer 2 loops, transitioning a port to the blocking state poses no risk of causing layer 2 loops, so there is no need to transition through the listening and learning states. Okay, let's go to question 3. Ports in which of the following states process received BPDUs? Select all correct answers. Pause the video now to think about the answers. Okay, the answers are all of them. A switch will process BPDUs received on any port, even in the blocking state. Although, as the example I showed earlier indicates, if a blocking port receives an inferior BPDU, it will ignore it until the previous BPDU ages out. But it still has to process the BPDU to identify that it's inferior. Okay, that's all for the quiz and this video. I hope it was helpful. Thanks for watching. Before finishing this video, let me thank my JCNP level channel members. To become a member, please click the join button under the video. Thanks to Jonathan Makara, Velva Jacob, Funny Dart, George Streeter, Nasir Chowdhury, Devin Suku, Gustavo BR, Pavel M, Mr. Erlison, Dragos Hirnea, Zakib Shah, Mayor Salman, Mazen Anderson, Vitaus 194, Gina Lindley, Mark Jackson, Bold 1C1U, Michael Carroll, Gerald Guillaume, Gabriel Braga, Hector Hernandez, Mara Tuba, Roji Kuriakos, Arpad Konives, 5 Feet, Owad, Daniel Brown, Tricky Mickey 123456, Scott Thompson, Jose Alvarez, Hussein Yavuz, Kevin Hayes, Samuel Tavares, Roger Bratseth, Mustafa Irsoy, Nasser Zahar, Brian Grant, Georgi Gemejev, Kyle, Arlen Plagaria, Dear Diso, Adelson Pereira, Farad69, Joyce Njoroge, Lucien Stoichitoyu, Madmark50484, Sean Powell, Alexander Stratan, Hiago Bicalho, Piotr Kaimov, Abdo Zizo, DMJ2, Kurt Nell, Preeti Dongave, Abu Bakar Berry, Omid Farakesh, Steve Cox, Jasper Yim, Wilmer Romero, Enigma G, Laurent Lam, Pedro Hartman, Ivano Capuano, Jefferson Steelflex, Sinan Sarisinar, Alejandro Okana, Burrell Campbell, Abhishek Sahu, Toxic Geo, Daniel Andrade, Vijay Kumar Pili, Jairo Francisco, Dedenoyu Diana, Hamudi Batman, Mike Crumby, Eliel Eliluli, and Dragos George. Sorry if I pronounced your name incorrectly, but thank you so much for your support. Thanks to you and my other supporters, I am able to make these videos and release them for free on YouTube, so I really appreciate the support. Another great way to support the channel is to like the video, leave a comment, subscribe, and most importantly, share this video with others. So, if this video was helpful, I'd appreciate it if you did any of those. Thanks for watching.